last one told you. So this the first one was 22-year-old male brought to the trials with the multiple stab injuries, left flank posteriorly, left flank and the right flank posteriorly, and one in the chest. And this momentum was coming out of the chest, the 7 intercostal space stab, and there was not much of abdominal signs, and the patient hemodynamic stable. The CT chest and abdomen was done and showed that there is stab in the 7th space, the surrounding emphysema, and minimal fluid in the perispheres area, no pneumoperitoneum. And this was suggested by one of the surgeons that since there is no CT has not shown any intra-abdominal injury, we should under local, we should push back the momentum and suture the wound. But we took him for the laparoscopy because I always believe all compound injuries, the principle of surgery is to be explored till its depth. And in this, I want to assess the depth, whether it's peritoneum or not. So this was a तुम्हारा सपोर्ट नहीं कर रहा है तेरे Now you have to give me more time, your system is not supporting the video. So the momentum was going from the abdomen to the chest and then coming out of the chest wall. And there was, see by time, 6 hours time, you can see their patient had lot of flakes in the abdomen. And this is the gastric perforation. So the stab has done from the chest wall, it's gone through the diaphragm and through the left lower liver, anterior and posterior surface, then the stomach. And after seeing that when we have explored rest of the abdomen, the right colon was lifted because there was a stab in the posterior and the right side, and the gastric perforation was closed in 2 layers, interpreted layers, and then chest tube. This is the chest view of the patient. Then the intercostal tube was put and the diaphragm was sutured. This patient, I think 5 to 6 hours after that. He was in another hospital, from there he has come. So after closing the, repairing the diaphragm with protein suture, we explored the right colon was explored before because we have ruled out the retropleural injury. Then the gastroperitoneal infection was opened and the posterior surface of the stomach was seen. There is no perforation. Small bowel was explored, and then the left colon was also explored because there was a two stab in the left flank posterior. So we wanted to rule out the retropleural injury or extrapleural injury to the colon. Yeah, drain was put and then surgery was completed. The another case is 17-year-old male came with a trial with a STS stab in the right side of the chest. Hemodynamic stable, diffuse tender abdomen guarding, and ultrasound revealed mild hemoperitoneum with laceration of the right lobe liver. So this will also be. Yeah, there was a stab in the left, right side, and you can see that the right lobe of the liver was torn, anterior and posterior and inferior surface, quite posteriorly. And this bleeding, since your thin slide, bleeding was closed with the bipolar cautery and gauze was put there. And just to wait for next exploration, you can see, I'll show you this, there was a hematoma in the this hepatic flexure was detected and explored, and there was actually hematoma in the mesentery of the transverse colon. That's why we wanted to explore the transverse colon. And then actually we found out there was transverse colon was all right. There was a mild stab in the splenic in a hepatic flexure from where the blood had collected, and then the whole of the intestine was explored. There was no other injury, so we could put a surgery cell at the sutures the repaired side of the liver, and the surgery was done. Third case was 25 year old male, the patient with the blunt injury in the face, and there was pain in the discomfort in the right left lower chest and upper abdomen. Hemodialysis patient also stable. The X-ray shows CST of doubtful shadow on the left side, very left diaphragmatic injury because we couldn't see the diaphragm properly. And ultrasound abdomen showed minimal fluid in the left subphrenic space and mild pleural effusion. Some hyperechoic shadows in the left chest. And the CT could not be done because that day our CT was down. So we took the patient for laparoscopy just to rule out other things. You can see that momentum was, I had gone in the chair, and that's why we could bring out the momentum. There was an injury to the left dome of diaphragm. And you should be gentle in taking out the tissues out, because I show you this. The moment there is some resistance for tissue to come out, whether you must be very gentle and do a counter traction or side direction of the rent. See this. Momentum is stomach is a little difficult to bring it out. So this slight dilatation of the rent and gradual gentle traction on the liver, the stomach gives way, and then you seem to see that the stomach which had gone there in 24 hours time, it was congested and the chemos, and then the diaphragm was repaired with the non-absorbable suture. You can use silk, you can use proline, nylon, whatever you want to use. And there was little difficulty, when you come medially, the part of the diaphragm behind the liver is little difficult to repair, but then it was repaired, and after that, repairing this diaphragm, you go back and see the condition of the stomach which was congested and slightly bluish was there. You have to see again, because there may be perforation there, there may be gangrenous patch there, then you have to tackle that also. You can't leave a perforation inside the abdomen. So you can see that color has improved gradually. We waited further and this improved, and then we left, nothing was done, and drain was put, and we could finish the surgery. This all was done laparoscopically. We have the more cases, but I'll just for stimulation to the subject, I have shown these three. Now on the discussion part. What is the role of laparoscopy? Is there any role of laparoscopic surgery in abdominal trauma? Yes, people say yes. Some people say no. If I ask you to raise hands, I think 50-50 will be there. And those who are in favor of this, they say it's a great advantage. Those who are not in favor, they say there's no role. You're just wasting time and putting the patient in more. But before this, I just wanted to tell you a few facts. That 12% of the trauma victims have abdominal injuries, and which are responsible for 10% of the trauma deaths. Out of these trauma deaths, missed abdominal injury remains the major preventable cause. Initial physical examination is only 65% accurate in assessing the extent of the abdominal trauma. And the other point I want to impress upon is the incidence of non-therapeutic laparotomy where you could have avoided laparotomy, you are not doing much in, once you go inside, is as high as 30%. See, the role of minimal size surgery is both diagnostic and therapeutic. The aim of any diagnostic tool is to identify the patients without intraabdominal injuries, to identify patients with injuries that do not require surgical intervention, and third is to identify the patients which have clinical occult injuries that require surgery. So does this laparoscopy fits in that or not, we have to see. And these are the various, you know, tools available, diagnostic tools available with us. So out of which CT scan, FAST, and diagnostic pattern LAVAS. So our diagnostic part of the laparoscopy surgery should match with them, results should match with them. And sensitivity and specificity we should see, and the hospital factors. Whether what facility your hospital has, whether you have a high-end laparoscopic set, whether you have blood bank facility, whether you have CT scan. So you have to define so many things and then make your protocols and then proceed first. So to evaluate the laparoscopy surgery and diagnostic modality, its advantages and disadvantages should be assessed against DPL, FAST, and CT. So you can see that it matches with them, all these, except that it is the invasive. CT scan is not invasive. So hospital factors are, what is the trauma load you have got? So what are the your experience with trauma? Availability of in-house surgical team, what assess multiple detectors, CT scan or other things are available or not. And the time lag between the, most important thing is time lag between the start of deterioration and reporting. Person who is looking after your absence, at what time he picks up the changes in the blood and deterioration of the patient. And then once he picks up the things, you decide to intervene the patient, to take the patient to OT, how much time is taken to actual starting the surgery, and dependence on others. So for me, if it was close, there is not much facilities, then I would rather do laparoscopy late in the evening rather than in the middle of the night when the things are not available. So laparoscopy is somewhat in infancy. It is underused. It is like a computer. When you use more, you do more miracles, you become more friendly with that. The actual role of laparoscopy is not only diagnostic, it is therapeutic also. I have shown you three videos which is therapeutic. And the advantage is that there is a fall in non-therapeutic laparotomies and all the advantages of mass. See, going through the literature, I have come across one thesis done from this hospital on role of laparoscopy in trauma. And in 1996, the sensitivity is reported by 25 to 88%, least for bowel. But in 2003, there was a paper, 78 cases, no biosensitivity, no death, no conversion to laparotomy. My experience, we have done around 50 cases. We had two cases of missed injuries. A case of liver injury was not assessed properly. We did laparotomy after 1 hour, after 2 hours, and the major debridement of the right lobe liver was done, and the cavity was packed. We were unable to stop bleeding, cavity was packed, and we explored it for 48 hours, and child was saved. So limitations is, the patient has to be in hemodynamic stable position. Retroperitoneal limitation, you can't explore much. Operator dependent, and there is a significant learning curve. Criticism from our friends. If I miss an injury in laparoscopy surgery, some people will criticize me. But if I do the same thing in laparotomy, nobody is criticizing me. The basic principles of treating and compound injury, this is the added advantage in pendant injury. See, once you do, see the abdomen, there is no pedal rent, so all penetrating in, they are not going inside, they cannot cause any injury to the intraabdominal organs. So this has given rise to a diagnostic gasless laparoscopy with 2 mm scope in the casualty itself, stab injury, casualty itself, they put a 2 mm scope and see that there is no pedal rent, pedal is intact, so there is no injury, nothing more to be done, and if there is pedal rent is there, take the patient to OT and do the proper laparoscopy. So these are our, you know, different, this is one case of isolated injury to the gallbladder. Patient had come to us after 7 days with fever and pain in the upper abdomen, and ultrasound showed the collection in the mortal pouch, aspirated, it was a pure bile. Thinking there is a, we have entered the gallbladder, we took the needle out, our radiologist friend said, why are you taking the needle out, you are in the collection. Then we collected, we aspirated the whole patient, after 2 days, repeat ultrasound showed again collection. We took the patient for laparoscopy surgery and diagnosed, but they couldn't see anything. The movement was just to inspect the undersurface of the liver. We lifted the fundus of the stomach, lifted the stomach up. Suddenly there was a gush of bile in the dorsal pouch and the gallbladder collapsed. Then we saw there was no injury. Then we filled up the gallbladder with the contrast and did the X-ray. You can see here, there is a double shed of the gallbladder. There's a bile, there's contrast leakage there. And there's this medial surface of the stomach, gallbladder. You can see there's a rent here. From here, the contrast is leaking. And rest of the bilirubin system is normal. The lab quality was done and the patient was all right. So one was converted and one missed in the, that's why I said in that case we explored the right colon, because there was a multiple stab injury I did, and there was posteriorly the gluteal region stab and the gluteal region. We didn't explore the right colon posteriorly, and we have to re-explore the patient after 48 hours. So message is, no laparoscopy is safe method in the evaluation and management of hemodynamic stable abdominal trauma patients. Each hospital should make its protocol to manage such cases depending on the facilities available, experience of the surgeon, and should not change on day-to-day basis, and should do medical auditing for its effectiveness. Thank you.
Thank you for your nice presentation, sir. I have one question. Apart from hemodynamic instability, does the presence of chest trauma or head injury contraindicate doing laparoscopy?
See, if the patient is hemodynamic stable, means all are unstable a little bit. What differentiates is instability is pulse is 150, BP is 60-70, not responding to fluid, then I don't do any laparoscopy in that case. But if the initial system they improve, we take the laparoscopy. A head injury itself is not a contraindication. If the patient is fit for laparoscopy, abdominal trauma injury, with a laparotomy, we do laparoscopy. It is not contraindicated. No chest injury is contraindicated. Only thing is, before taking the patient for surgery, if there is hemopneumothorax or pneumothorax or hemothorax, we put a chest tube and then take the patient for, because we have to do it.
In fact, I've seen and heard Dr. Tehan speaking on the role of laparoscopy in many conferences, and I myself am doing this procedure many times, and of course the criteria laid by him is very apt, that patient should be hemodynamically stable and you should be able to devote time to explore each and every quadrant and not miss any injury. In fact, I can see some people from the audience willing to ask some questions. Anybody asking?
In the presence of diaphragmatic injury, is there any difficulty in achieving the hemodynamic?
Not much. And diaphragm is one organ which is laparoscopically is very easy to approach. You can miss diaphragm injury in laparoscopy. It's very high up. You miss or difficult to even to repair in the laparoscopy.
Excuse me, I'm Dr. Kalasuri, Mashhad, Iraq. I'm a general and laparoscopic surgeon. Thank you for your nice presentation. I'd like to tell my personal experience. We have more than 50 cases of lower chest trauma and manage them with thoracoscopy, primarily, and then thoracoscopy, we explore the thoracavity and hemostasis and repair the lung if it injured, and then diaphragm was injured, I repair it, and then after that we can do laparoscopy exploration or not. In my opinion, thoracoscopy primarily is better than laparoscopy in the trauma of the lower chest. Thank you.
Yeah, we are doing thoracoscopy in trauma because there was topic was abdomen, so I didn't carry those videos. So we have done tackled the right mammary artery bleed, which is continuously bleeding, thoracoscopically, intraoperatively, foreign body, clotted hemothorax. So this we have done all with the thoracoscopy and mild laceration.
Thank you, sir. Masood Sadruzai from Afghanistan. According to the war surgery in our country, we have so much wait time. And my experience, according to the question of that doctor, besides the other contraindication, there is two main contraindications also in this patient, mostly in late stage of peritonitis. Because according to the distension and illness of the stomach and also rigidity of the abdominal wall, there is very small access area and working space for these patients. I think in late stage of peritonitis also, it will be very difficult to access to the abdomen and do some procedures. Besides the hemiplegic and white peritonitis, that they don't have some such a clinical state.
No, I agree with you. Yeah, no, I agree with you. Late stages of peritonitis, any peritonitis, like see in perforation also, in obstruction also, when there is a lot of distension, see, guarding is taken care by relaxants. If there should bowel distension should not be there, so that you have enough space to walk. So that is like any other in not in trauma, other peritonitis also bowel perforation. Suppose patient comes to you after 5-6 days, there lot of ileus, lot of distension. That you can't do. That is same holds good here also. But here trauma is usually the patient come early. So that but ileus is not there. That is not a much of problem. Like this trauma injury came to us after 5-6 hours. And then we could manage this problem. I have done gunshot injury in the which is going through the epigastrium. That was the anterior surface of left lobe of liver, posterior surface stomach, anterior surface, posterior surface stomach. And posterior surface stomach was bleeding. None, liver was not bleeding, anterior surface stomach was bleeding, posterior surface stomach was bleeding. And we opened the lesser sac and repaired the, you know, stopped the bleeding first, then explored rest of the abdomen. And there was a mild laceration of the, because the track was like that, there was mild laceration of the spleen, lower part of the spleen, and that was left alone, putting it just in surgical and left alone.
In the tea break.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for a very, very illuminating presentation. Thank you.